Good morning, team, or should I say good daylight, team. Morning hasn't started well. We're supposed to get up real early this morning. Get up on the Rangitiki, have a fly fish, a solo fly fish this morning. Unfortunately, my oldest daughter needed to be dropped off at the airport because she's a flight attendant. And then she left her security swipe cards at home, so I had to rush back and get those. Then I realized, in my haste, I didn't have a charging cable for my iPhone. So I've had to rush into work to get my spare one from there. And now, it is daylight. What's the big deal with daylight? Well, I always like to be first on the water, so I don't have to share it with anybody. And it's always my intention to get to the water first, try and beat everyone. I don't care if I've got to get up at 2 o'clock in the morning, but I want to get on the water first and I want to fish that virgin water. But I would say that I will be not the first on the water this morning. So today's mission is all about christening a fly rod. You're probably thinking, well, whoop-de-doo. Well, normally I wouldn't worry about it. I'd introduce the rod just like I did with my check nymph rod. Go, oh, hey guys, I'm going to go out and learn how to check nymph or christen this check nymph rod. This one here is a little bit different today. For most of you guys that follow my channel, follow Gav Boo Boo's and Big O and Harris's channel, you're starting to see us use a logo a lot on our videos. This one right here on my chest. Alright. That's a group, for some of you guys that have followed me for a wee while. That's a group we created, a close Facebook group of a select few members, hunters, fly fishermen, divers, sea fishermen, outdoorsmen, close group to 100 guys, where we have a set of rules. Only guys are accepted in that group, that guys that share the same passion, share the same thoughts and ideas, the same ethos about giving back, sharing knowledge. One of those guys in that group, who I've come to know very, very well, is an Australian old kaumātua, old fella, who, oh, just unbelievable, mate. It's an unbelievable kindness of this man, who we haven't met before. He's just turned into a mate. Such a good mate, and I can guarantee you, guys on our page would vouch for that. This old bugger does things that blows me away. The support he shows for the brothers on our group is just amazing. So this old bugger, top man that he is, has sent me a brand new, custom-made, handmade cane, split cane fly rod, 5/6 weight, out of the kindness of his heart. So this video is about christening that rod. I've never cast or never caught a fish on a cane fly rod. So this is what this video is about. Going up the Rangitiki, getting that rod christened, and pretty much a thank you to Hank Robert Bradford.
I was in the pub last night and I was talking to an old bloke who worked on this property from 1958 to 1965. And he said, where are you going fishing tomorrow? And I said, I'm going to Mount Pleasant at Bubunda. And he said, well, be careful of the tiger snakes. And that's why I've got this little beauty. If I get bitten, I'm not looking at it, I'm not going to walk back to the car. I'm pressing this and getting the helicopter in. Put me straight in hospital. Hopefully it'll save me life. But that's what you should always carry, fellas. It doesn't matter where you go. Always carry your equipment.
We now return to your regular programming.
So I'll show you the rod once I get out there. String it up and talk a little bit about Hank as I go fly fishing, because pretty special old bugger. It's not often you meet guys that are just unbelievably kind, is the way to put it. No BP this morning, running too late with all the dramas. Had to have a coffee and a little bite to eat at work just then, so we'll get up to the Rangitiki, we'll get pulled up, so stand by. Enjoy the road trip, and we'll see you up on the Rangitiki. Check out our water. Check out our water. It's not crystal clear, but it's certainly fishable. More fishable than it was the other day when we came and had to fish the Kawhatau. And I am the second. All right, so here's this rod. This is how it came in this beautiful tube. It's called Richard Valley Rods from Canada. The other thing that makes this rod special is that chap there, Richard Durling, unfortunately has passed away, so definitely a collector's item, so it makes it even more special. So let's get it all tooled up, get it all dressed up and get it ready. Right, just check this beautiful work of art out. Beautiful piece of craftsmanship. Look at that. Rick's Valley Rods Canada, 8'5" 6" weight. Look at the finish on that, guys. Well, she's like a bit of a noodle though, but I've had a couple of casts of her at home and it sure spit some line. I just hope that these fish in this bloody ringer-tickie don't break it, that's all. But yeah, let's get out and get a tight line on this rod, eh? Beautiful little rod. All right, let's hit the river. The question is, where are those other guys? Oh, where could you be? If you watch my YouTube videos, you know that I'm coming up behind you. Anyway, there's plenty of river here for us to fish. Like I said, I just want a handful of tight lines, christen this beautiful rod, and get home, post up the video. Tautoko Hank. Well, let's get into it. Found the chap, spin fisherman just heading up there. I don't know if you can see with the sunstrike. Good bloke, good yarn with him. Here, so if he spin fished it, I definitely got some chances with my fly, so awesome. That makes me feel happy. Righty, let's see what this little baby can do. And we're in, just like that. Here you go, me. Let's put a clean fly rod. First fish on the Rangitiki. Too much. That's what I love about this river. Just love this river. Let's put this fella back. Thank you, bro. Thank you for helping me christen my new split cane fly rod. Come on, brother. We got one on the dry. Oh shit. Bugger! And now, and we lost the trailing nymph. Bastard. Oh no, we didn't. We lost the bend of the hook. That's no good. Yeah. He's in the big water. Oh, not again. No. You'd like to see what that's hooked on, don't you? Feel like the waves of the ocean. The top of me, oh, so can I come up for? There must be somebody swimming. Oh no, we still got him. He's feeling strange. We're just long enough that I lose my fear that I won't come up again. Yeah, and yeah. And I'll sink to the bottom of what I am.
I go down with a drink in my hand.
Maybe another that one.
Was the problem. All began.
Oh,
said I'm addicted and I can't change. The path I walk, it remains the same. Yep. But if I get swept away, playing these games.
This. This rod is so flexible. I'm not hitting the hook well. Fuck. Correct. Righty, I have decided that Hank, the cane fly rod, that's my name for the rod is Hank. She always gives you a rod's a name. Hank the fly rod can have a rest now, because Nympho, my check Nympho rod, will be down the back there getting jealous. So. You've done well, brother. You slayed up the rangatiki. Well done. Right. Gonna go back down and get a check nymph on. See how we get on with that.
Oh, first cast point nymph.
No, we got only a little time. So like it or not, we gon' be drinking wine. No need to stop.
The new
so we see
and the old
sunshine.
And the fish.
Start at the top.
And the fish.
So we ease our world, man. Yeah. No one lies without you. Think of the cost of what you do. To me, you really mean something. Running away will fix enough.
Purple rain does it again.
Much better. Know that I'll wait until I'm old.
Cheers, brother.
See your face again. Know that I'll wait until I'm old and gray just to see your face again. Know that I'm watching every minute.
That's our biggest fish to date on the chicken. That's maybe about 4 pounds. Not bad, eh? Not too bad at all. Anyway, he's coming back to the smoke. If you ever want a nice tasting trout, get the ones that are lovely and orange and pink. Look at that. He's going to be tasty as. Tasty as. Well, I think that's me. I'm done. All I've done is fished. Started down there. And fished up there, and that's I've just stayed here for since half past seven. Yeah, it's half past 11 now, so I've caught I lost count. Maybe 20 fish. So I don't know. Just one of those sessions that you have. It just absolutely goes off. I still love to get over there and fish that side. Over there, that looks good. But I've had enough. Time to go home. All right, I lied. I couldn't help myself. But jumping here, just one more flick. That's the last fish of the day. That's the last one. So, there it is. Awesome rod. Thank you so much, Hank. I know pushed it through its paces today. I don't know how many fish I got on this, probably about 8 and 9, but thought it was going to break there on a couple of big fish, but that's awesome, brother. Thanks for the rod, thanks for everything. Hope you guys enjoyed that little mission. Quite a few fish hooked, quite a few fish lost. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next mission.
Oh, that'll wait until I'm old.